hip joint, type synovial, variety ball and socket variety. Ball and socket variety. Articular ends proximally lunate surface of acetabulum. See, this half shoe shaped structure present in the acetabulum is the articulating part, and this is the acetabular fossa and acetabular knots. These are the non-articular part of the acetabulum. So the head of the femur articulates in the lunate surface of the acetabulum. Distally, head of femur, it is spherical. In the center of the head, there is a pit known as fovea capitis, which gives attachment for ligamentum teres of head of femur. Both the articular surfaces are lined by hyaline articular cartilage. Ligaments. Number one, capsule. Number two, iliofemoral ligament. Number three, pubofemoral ligament. Number four, ischiofemoral ligament. Number five, transverse ligament of the acetabular notch. Number six, ligamentum teres or round ligament of head of femur. Capsule, it is a loose fibrous sac which encloses the joint cavity. Its inner surface and the non-articular part of the hip joint are lined by synovial membrane. Attachment. Proximally, the capsule is attached to the rim of the acetabulum and the outer margin of the transverse ligament of the acetabular notch. It is attached proximal to acetabular labrum. It is a fibrocartilaginous ribbon like structure which is attached to the rim of the acetabulum. Okay. It increases the concavity and the surface area of the acetabulum for the articulation of head of femur. Distally, the capsule is attached to, anteriorly to the intertrochanteric line. This is the intertrochanteric line. Anteriorly to the intertrochanteric line. Inferiorly to the base of lesser trochanter, to the base of lesser trochanter. Posteriorly, this is the intertrochanteric crest, but it is attached 1 cm above the intertrochanteric crest. So posteriorly, it is attached to the neck, posterior surface of the neck of femur, 1 cm proximal to the intertrochanteric crest. So it is attached here, and superiorly it is attached to the base of the greater trochanter, base of the greater trochanter. So this is the attachment of the capsule. Iliofemoral ligament or ligamentum medullo. It is a strongest ligament and it is also known as anti-gravity ligament. It is a Y-shaped ligament. Inverted Y-shaped ligament. It is a inverted Y-shaped ligament. Attachment. Proximally, it is attached to lower part of the anterior inferior iliac spine. Lower half of the anterior inferior iliac spine. Distally, it splits into two bands. It splits into two bands. Okay, superior band, inferior band. Okay. The superior band is attached to the upper part of the intertrochanteric line. The inferior band is attached to the lower part of the intertrochanteric line. In between the two bands, the capsule is weak. Pubofemoral ligament. Proximally, it is attached to iliopubic eminence. Iliopubic eminence. Distally, it runs deep to the lower band or the inferior band of the iliofemoral ligament, where it blends with the capsule. Ischiofemoral ligament. Proximally, it is attached to the posterior inferior part of the acetabulum. Distally, the ligament runs spirally and it merges or it blends with the capsule of the hip joint. Some of the fibers runs to the base of the greater trochanter. Once again, I'll repeat the ligaments. So this is the hip joint. So this is anterior superior iliac spine. This is anterior inferior iliac spine. So that from the lower part of the anterior inferior iliac spine, a ligament is attached. That is the iliofemoral ligament. So the iliofemoral ligament, proximally it is attached to the lower part of the anterior inferior iliac spine. Distally, it is attached to upper and lower part of the intertrochanteric line, because the ligament divides into two bands, upper part and lower part. So the upper band or the superior band is attached to the upper part of the intertrochanteric line. The inferior part is attached to the lower part of the intertrochanteric line. Pubofemoral ligament. Proximally, it is attached to, this is ilium, this is pubis, there is an eminence. Iliopubic eminence. So proximally it is attached to the iliopubic eminence, superior ramus of the pubis, and obturator crest. This margin is known as obturator crest. So from here the ligament comes in. It is a triangular ligament. So from above it is broad, below it is narrow, and distally it merges with the capsule. Ischiofemoral ligament. This is the ischial tuberosity and this is the acetabulum. The ligament is attached here. So it is attached to the posterior medial to acetabulum. Superolateral to the ischial tuberosity on the body of the ischium, the ligament is attached. Distally, it runs obliquely or spirally and blends with the capsule. Transverse ligament of the acetabulum. It bridges between the two ends of the lunate surface of the acetabulum. There is a notch, acetabular notch. So this notch is converted into a foramen by transverse acetabular ligament or transverse ligament of the hip joint. A round ligament of head of femur. It is triangular in shape. Apex is attached to the fovea centralis or fovea capitis present in the head of the femur. Distally, it is attached to the transverse ligament of the acetabular notch. Relations of the hip joint. Anteriorly, the hip joint is related to, number one, stated of rectus femoris, number two, iliopsoas, number three, pectineus. Anterior to these three structures, there is a nerve, artery, and a vein. The femoral nerve lies anterior to the stated of rectus femoris. So it is separated from the capsule of the hip joint by the striated of rectus femoris. The femoral artery is separated from the capsule of the hip joint by the iliopsoas tendon. The femoral vein is separated from the hip joint by the pectineus muscle. So these are the anterior relations. Superior relation. Superiorly, the hip joint is related to reflected head of rectus femoris, gluteus medius, and gluteus minimus. Posteriorly, it is related to number 1 gluteus maximus, piriformis, tendon of obturator internus with the superior and inferior gamelli, obturator externus, and quadratus femoris. The obturator externus is separated from the quadratus femoris by medial circumflex femoral artery. The sciatic nerve is separated from the hip joint by the superior gamellus, tendon of obturator internus, inferior gamellus, and quadratus femoris. Movements. Flexion of the hip joint. It is by iliacus, psoas major, and pectineus muscle. Extension. Gluteus maximus, hamstring muscles, and tensor fascia lata. Adduction. Adduction is by adductor longus, brevis, adductor magnus, and gracilis muscle. Abduction. Abduction is by gluteus medius and minimus, supported by tensor fascia lata. Medial rotation. Tendon of iliopsoas, pectineus, adductor magnus, adductor brevis. Lateral rotation. These muscles are short muscles which are responsible for lateral rotation of the thigh. So the lateral rotation is by piriformis, superior gamellus, inferior gamellus, obturator internus, quadratus femoris. Circumduction. It is a combined movement of flexion, extension, adduction, and abduction. So the muscles responsible for producing these movements are responsible for producing the circumduction. Applied anatomy. Dislocation of hip joint. Okay. Posterior dislocation of the hip joint is very common. There are two types. Okay, one is congenital dislocation and the next one is traumatic dislocation. Congenital dislocation of hip joint is very common than any other joint in the body. There is a posterior dislocation due to dysplasia, that is defective formation of the posterior part of the rim of acetabulum. So this is the posterior part of the rim of the acetabulum. There is a dysplasia, that is defective formation of the posterior part of the acetabulum. So this results in the posterior dislocation of the hip joint. Whereas in traumatic dislocation, okay, the posterior dislocation is due to fracture of the posterior part of the rim of the acetabulum and the posterior part of the capsule. Okay. This is very rare. Okay. This takes place when the thigh is flexed and adducted, like a driving in a car. So when a person is driving in a car, then when there is a severe blow in the knee joint, okay, at the knee, what happens? Since the thigh is flexed and adductor, see the head is already partly exposed outside. So it results in fracture of the posterior part of the rim of the scapulum and the tearing or the damage of the posterior part of the capsule. This results in posterior dislocation of the hip joint. Number 2, Treadline-Berg's sign. See, it is a sign which test, which is done to find the stability of the hip joint. The stability of the hip joint depends on 3 factors. Number 1, the head of the femur should fit into the acetabulum in normal condition. Number 2, the neck and the shaft angle should be normal. The angle of the neck should be normal with the shaft of the femur. Number 3, the function of gluteus, medius and minimus should be normal. If any one of the factors, these factors is defective, then the Treadline-Berg sign shows positive. How to test? Okay, when a person is standing in one leg with the opposite side leg raised off the ground, okay, the body should be straight. If the body sags on the unsupported opposite side, then the test is positive. So this is Treadline-Berg's sign. Aspiration of hip joint. See, a person is standing like this, okay. For instance, in order to show the position, I'm telling you, okay. Aspiration of hip joint is done, okay, by inserting the needle. This is the anterior aspect of the hip joint, this is the posterior aspect of the hip joint. Okay. Aspiration of the hip joint is done by inserting the needle from anterior, okay. So the needle is inserted, okay, medially and backwards, okay, medially and backwards, and okay, just 5 cm below the anterior superior iliac spine. The needle is inserted, okay, medially, upwards and backwards, okay, just 5 cm below the anterior superior iliac spine. Weaver's bottom. It is a condition in which there is an inflammation of the ischial bursa, and this condition is known as Weaver's bottom or driver's bottom.